Can you walk me through the certain parts that he acted wrongly
okay.
and how he should have handled it?
Okay, a couple things. First of all, there's an antecedent to this video where the second he pulls her over, ma'am, I'm stopping you for an improper lane change. Very civil discourse. He asked her for her license plate, very pleasant conversation right before that. At some point, he's talking to her, and he asks her to please put out her cigarette. I've done that before. And every
police officer,
yes, yeah.
Why?
Because I'm talking to you, and you're
blowing smoke in your face.
It's disrespectful. It's
Any
not
other
healthy.
Reason?
I'm not smoking. No, no, okay. really no.
Okay.
But at that point, by the way, you don't have to put it out, but it's certainly courteous to. At some point, something escalates where he feels to get out of the car, which, by the way, is lawful. I can order you out of the car. There are some state laws that go to that point, but the state or Supreme Court law, Pennsylvania versus Mims, I think it was, that said a police officer can order you out of the car on a traffic stop. So she has to comply. What I think most police officers, I think where you could find fault with the officer, and many people, myself included, not only do you have to do the right thing, but you have to sound good and look good. So the way you speak to people, even if they're being...
The tone, the language. Yeah.
Well, at some point, your tone is going to be sharp. Ma'am, get out of the car. And if they don't, you can escalate your tone. That was it, the progression. But again, we don't see in the car. When he leans in, I wouldn't be leaning in the car like that personally. I don't think that's a safe thing to do from an officer safety standpoint. What did she do in the car? Did she scratch him? Did she push him? Did he perceive that as a conduct that was approaching assault? I don't know. It certainly escalated to a point that it shouldn't have gotten to.
Professor, I want your perspective. You've seen the video. I want your interpretation, A, and B, as far as these issues that David brings up, just from a legal perspective, what were her rights in that situation?
I have seen that video, Brooke, and I have to tell you, as a former prosecutor, as an African-American, and as an American citizen who hopes that he lives in a free country, I'm horrified by what I see. It's unconstitutional. First of all, the stop. Classic example of driving while black. This African-American woman driving, cop is tailing her. She pulls over simply to get out of his way, and that's when he gives her a ticket. Then the asking, put out the cigarette. The cop, your other guest is right. He does, that's not a order. She doesn't have to put out the cigarette.
It's a courtesy.
Yeah, and the reason that he asked her to get out of the car is because she doesn't put out the cigarette. He feels disrespected. Well, again, your other guest is right. There is a case that says the cops can order you out the car, but that's if they feel concerned for their safety, not if they feel disrespected. And then the
not
use
true.
Of deadly force. Why? We don't even know why she was arrested. At this, we don't see a crime. We see a traffic infraction. We don't see a crime committed. Again, and the police report is a lie. He leaves out the stun gun. He leaves out the cigarette. There's no reason to trust this officer's credibility. I don't think the citizens of Texas are safe with this man with a gun and the power to arrest.